parted everything. Like you see the back. First you want to do the front. Like I said, starting from the center of the head going up. Then you see I got the back. I did the sides just going straight down towards my ear. And then connecting these two. And the same on this side. As you can see, I'm still working on it. I'm slow, I know. But as I'm braiding my hair, I'm braiding my hair all the way through. I'm using rubber bands. And I wanted to kind of tell you about the rubber bands that you might want to make sure you use. Pretty much everybody buys these anyway, the Proclaim Super Stretch. But like how it says right here, will not break your hair. A lot of people don't understand that they're... most rubber bands are actually breaking their hair and giving them split ends, and a lot of the time hair weaves are kind of used either just because you're like me and you like to change your styles a lot, or also transition looks while your hair is short and you want to grow it out. But in general, even if you don't want to grow it out, just try and keep your hair healthy. Who doesn't want healthy hair? Make sure you use these type of rubber bands because most of them will break your hair. So that was all I was gonna add to that. You see I have them all throughout. Okay y'all, it's pretty late. It's actually 2 o'clock and I'm kind of debating on if I'm gonna sew it in tonight, but I at least have my braids out of the way. So anyway, basically you guys see again what I did, my parting, everything like that. And I braided my hair straight down. I can actually take this bottom part out if I want. Oh, hold on. One thing I did is that not only do I have the rubber bands at the end of my braids, but I also put them where the braids are no longer sticking to my head. And I did that because that holds it better for after a while. Like I said, these don't break your hair. But after a while, the oils in your hair is actually break the rubber bands. So, which for me is preferable. And mostly by that time, your hair, even if you don't have African American hair, and you think, oh, my hair is so fine, it'll just unravel. Actually, it really shouldn't, because it'll be kind of pressed into that position. But there can be some small unravelings, which isn't a big deal though, but I like to put a second rubber band there. I've never really had a problem with it, even when I didn't do it, so don't, like, get all self-conscious about it. But, yeah, I think I'm about to go take my shower, so, I don't know, maybe I'll get back to this tomorrow. So, what I've done is, I took my weaving thread, where did I put it? There it is. I like to use a brown since my hair is darker than it, but it'll still blend for the most part. But at least when I'm cutting the weave out, or normally I have my dad or somebody cut it out for me, they can see. What I do is I stretch out the string about an arm and a half's length away, and I thread the needle. You see I got my two little pieces over here, my needle over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap it around the needle 2 to 3 times, and then just hold my little circles and pull them all the way. And what that does is that creates a nice neat knot at the end. For those of you who have never sewn anything before anyway. That should be a quick tip. Okay. Now what I'm going to do to get the needle on my left, I don't know if you guys saw what I just did. I pierced through the actual weaving of the hair. And I'm going to wrap again twice. Hold my little wraps and pull it through. And now it is all the way down, secure. There's no little loop knots throughout my string. It's just nice and securely on there. Okay. Okay. I zoomed you guys in because I want to make sure you can see this. I didn't feel in my last hair weave tutorial that it was clear enough. So, what I'm going to do is take the weft. It doesn't matter which side because this isn't a full hair weave or like a quick weave or anything. I'm just going to hold the hair close to the rubber band at the base that I showed you guys how to do. And I'm going to loop the needle into the braid. And be careful not to scrape your scalp. Okay, and I'm going to twist it around the needle so it'll make a quick knot. And I'm going to do that twice.